When we're talking about traveling steps in ballet dance, so the first thing is like, oh, they're quite limited. Ballet dance is usually dance on spot. It's more about oscillations. And there are some steps like arabesque or chassé step or maybe chanet turns that we use to walk around the stage. But in reality, the topic of traveling steps is so rich and so full with different details. Pretty much any step can be transformed into traveling step if you have a little bit of creativity. Traveling step or traveling combo can be performed in different manners. It can be for oriental style or for folklore style. It has certain meaning or functionality. There are some steps that we typically would use in a certain part of the songs, and there is timing for when to use them. So all this is a huge topic, which I think a lot of dancers don't realize how much richness is there to dive. So in this video, you will see a compilation of three tutorials. One will be about a typical ballet dance move, hip arch, and how you can transform it into a traveling step. Then you will see a combo, a traveling combo with simple traveling hip drop and a couple other variations, but in two different styles, one for oriental, one for folklore. And also movements are the same, actual movements, but they look different because the manner of how you perform them is different. And the last video of this compilation will be a traveling chassé step, which is one of the typical intro steps. That's how we enter the stage. But an important moment is when we enter stage. So the last snippet will be to show and bring your attention that there is musicality of when you use those kind of steps. All these little clips, they are from a full 20-minute tutorials, technique drills at the Iana Dance Club. They are also part of our very special intensive on traveling steps. So if you want to dive deeper, go there. It's ianadanceclub.com. But I hope you will also enjoy this video and learn something new. Afterwards, comment what caught your attention and what you like the most. And I'm looking forward to seeing the progress in your practice. And so I want to bring your attention that as a dancer, you're not entering right from the first note of the song, and even not always right away with rhythmic part. Listen to the song when you're choreographing and see, oh, that's the actual beginning. This is just transition. Now we start. Three. 4, 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8. And this combo can be done in oriental style or it can be done in folkloric. So the first oriental is very elegant. We keep posture and we're trying to isolate mostly hips. Let's try it. 1, 2, very elevated upper body. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This side, let's do folkloric. It's a little bit bigger, a little bit loose. 1, 2, you can add this little plie. 1, 2, vishimi. 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can even lean forward on this accent. Now, go on one side, let's start from this one. So you're standing on one leg, another is supported, and I'm gonna go with hip accent down, 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 down. But I don't want to do simple hip accent down, I want to make it super sharp. So my opposite glute, whenever hip goes down, it squeezes, it engages. This sharpness from down, down, it comes from opposite glute, and my knee gets super straight. Almost like a little dance in his arms. I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial. If you want to study with me more in depth and on a regular basis, check out the Iana Dance Club, where I post full classes, full dance workouts on different topics, as well as choreography explanations and dance-related lectures. You can find all details at ianadanceclub.com. It's IANA Dance Club. iana.com. And of course, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like, comment, and share it with your friends.